Hey yoga friends, welcome back to another video. Today's video is all about power, finding your power, tapping into it and keeping it. So I hope that you enjoy. Go ahead and roll out your mat and be prepared to bring a little bit of balance in your day, as well as finding and, like I said, keeping your power. So let's go ahead and begin. Lifting the heart towards the sky, extending the fingertips towards your mat, fingers spread wide, palms facing forward, kneecaps are lifted, your quads are engaged, and your navel is being pulled in towards your spine. You're standing in a proud, powerful mountain pose. Try to relax your face. Inhale, lift the arms towards the sky. Reaching tall, and exhale, release the hands down. Once again, the palms face forward. Inhale, reach the arms up, and bring your fingertips to connect overhead. Exhale, drop the hands down. Shoulders are down, chest is lifted, palms are forward. Strong mountain pose. Inhale, reach up, look up this time, lifting your chin towards the sky, fingertips touch overhead, and as we exhale, bring your hands down to the heart. Standing tall once more. Inhale through the nose, and exhale through the mouth. Let's interlace our fingers, bring that fist to our chin. As we inhale, we're going to lift the elbows towards the sky, and as we exhale through the mouth, making that sound, we bring the elbows down and they touch at the bottom. So elbows connect to start, standing tall, inhale powerfully, exhale, release. Stand tall, bring your hands forward so your fingers are still connected, thumbs are crossed, and feel those shoulder blades open. Drop your chin. Let's go ahead and look forward. Bring the fingers in and then just turn your palms towards the front of the room. Now your palms are open, fingertips intertwined. Inhale, lift the arms up, reach up, nice beautiful stretch, pull the hips forward slightly, and exhale, lean to the right. So press the hips to the left, keep your chin lifted, and lean to the right. Inhale, we come up, and exhale, we lean to the left. So we're pressing those hips to the right, try to keep both arms straight here, roll that right shoulder back. Inhale, we come up, we reach up, and exhale, just bring your hands down, palms connecting, releasing the fingers, and you're meeting once again, and hands at heart center. Exhale, lean forward. So hinge forward from the hips, keep the legs straight. Breathe, and as you exhale, release your hands down. And let the hands hang for a moment. Maybe your hands can touch the mat or the ground right away. Maybe not. Doesn't matter. Just hang out here for a while. Take a few breaths. But I want you to keep your legs straight. So you're going to feel that stretch in the hamstrings. And you're going to shift your weight into your toes. Noticing how that may challenge your balance in a different way. Keeping it active here by keeping those legs engaged. Inhale, bring it up to 90. So flat back, look forward. And as we exhale, let's go ahead and bend both knees, hands drop to the mat. Lift that right foot up, step the right foot back on our mat. We are in high lunge. Lift your chest from that thigh, fingertips barely touching your mat. Use your core, use your power. Find the core here, not momentum. And as we lift, we're going to reach the arms forward in line with our ears. Biceps, ears, same line. Fingertips actively engaged, reaching forward as if you're going to touch the front room. Feel that core engaged and feel that left quad working. Now rise up with the core, not momentum, high lunge, hold here. And breathe. Let's add a little bit of movement into this pose. We're going to open up, so the right arm is going to go forward and left arm goes back, adding in a twist. Now try not to lean forward with the shoulder in front of that knee. Try to keep everything in one line. If you can, gaze back. If not, no big deal. Inhale, bring it back to center. How does that left quad feel? Make sure you're dropping into that knee. We don't want it to come up here. Keep it intense. Keep the power flowing in your body and open up into a twist once again. Right arm forward, left arm back. Inhale, we lift. Third one, let's open into that twist. Hold, breathe. One thing you can do when trying to find your power is try to find calm, stillness. Inhale, we lift. And exhale, drop the hands down to the mat. Right palm stays where it is, and left arm reaches up towards the sky. And breathe. Power is being able to remain calm in situations that you may be a little uncomfortable in. That's also yoga. Exhale, left hand drops down. We're going to lift that right leg up, nice and slow. Bring your hands back to the heart. We are in Warrior Three. Straighten that left leg. And we're going to bring that right knee to our chest. So lift that knee up, stand tall, and exhale, kick back, Warrior Three. How's the balance? If you fall out, it's all right. Come back in. Slowly bring it in, knee to chest, and exhale, kick that foot back, Warrior Three. Hold here. Let's do it for the third time. Knee comes in, we find ourselves standing. And exhale, kick it back. Bend that left knee, gradually drop the right toes back to the mat. Inhale, lift both arms. And exhale, drop that right knee to the mat. Lift the right knee up, straighten the leg. Right knee drops down, and we lift. Down for three, lift, find your power, use that leg, four, lift, and five, lift, hold here, drop the right heel down, Warrior Two, shoulders stacked, gazing forward, strong warrior, gaze back to make sure that right arm is in line with the left, left knee is not protruding over that ankle, if it is, just walk that foot forward. Drop a little bit deeper. Exhale, cartwheel the hands down to the mat and step the left foot back to meet the right. We are in plank, hips level with the shoulders. Core is engaged. We're going to pike our hips into down dog, but before we do, focus not on the shoulders or the legs, focus on that core. The core is what is going to move you here. Slowly hug your hips. Come back into plank. And down dog. Use the core, not momentum. Slowly come into plank. Third one. Down dog. Plank. Down dog. One more like this, plank, hold, and down dog. Now we're going to, from down dog, step the right foot forward to the outside of our right hand. Feel that right
right hip open and step the foot back into down dog. Left foot steps forward to the outside of the left hand and back on the exhale. Inhale right and exhale back. Inhale left and exhale back. Inhale right, third time, back, left, and back. Use your core, right, and back, left. Really try to step the foot in line with the hand, back, right, back, and left, back. Downward facing dog, hold here, breathe. I hate it when I wear the wrong shirt. The shirts that suffocate your face as you're trying to be in down facing dog. Just roll the shoulders out, breathe. Look forward at the top of your mat and walk or hop your feet forward depending on how you're feeling when you're practicing. And just allow yourself to hang out. And breathe in this forward fold. Keep the legs straight. Notice how this forward fold feels compared to that first one. Maybe you take your hands and rub the back of your legs if the hamstrings are tight. Now let's go ahead and come all the way up. Reverse swan dive. Reach the arms up towards the sky. Push the hips forward, falling back slightly. And exhale, stand tall. Hands to the heart, hinge forward from the hips, strong chest guiding you forward. Hold here, drop the hands down, forward fold, come up to 90. Exhale, you can bend your knees to step the hands to the mat, and we're going to step the left foot back on our mat. So we're going to meet in that high lunge to start. So first, we lift our chest from that right thigh. We don't want to drop the weight into that thigh. Make sure the knee and ankle are on the same line. If they're not on the same line, just walk that right foot forward. Now we're gonna lift our arms forward as well. Bring the biceps in line with the ears. Hold, breathe, balance. Building some fire in that right quad. And use your core, not momentum, to come into high lunge. And settle into this pose for a moment. Keep your arms lifted towards the sky. Try to keep the face relaxed. So even if you're feeling some tension build in that right quad, just breathe through it. Feel power here. You have the power to relax in any pose. Then we're going to twist. We're going to open up the left arm forward, right arm back. Keep the shoulders aligned with the hips. Try not to reach forward with the shoulders. Gaze back if you can at that right hand. Inhale, we bring both arms back up. And exhale, we take both hands out. Inhale, both arms back. And exhale, we twist, we open. Third one, let's do two more. Inhale, we open, right knee stays bent, and exhale, twist. Let's do it again. Inhale, lift, and exhale, open, twist, gaze back. Inhale, both arms lift. Hold here. Breathe. Exhale, drop both hands to the mat. Left hand stays where it is. Right arm to the sky. Gaze down, drop the right hand to the mat. We're going to bring our hands to the heart, shift the weight forward, keep that left foot from the mat, straighten the right knee, right leg. Find your balance. Right quad may be on fire, breathe through it. Warrior three. We're going to bring that left knee in towards our chest, and as we do so, we stand tall. And we breathe. Now you may likely notice that the right side feels completely different than the left did.
That's normal. Kick it back, warrior three. We bring that knee in once more on the inhale, and we exhale, kick it back. Use your power, use control here. Bring it in, and we exhale it back. Bring it in, and exhale it back. One more time, let's bring that knee in, lift it up. Slow down the heart rate, slow down the breathing, exhale it back. With control, bend that right knee, step the left toes back to your mat. Inhale, lift your arms, high lunge. Drop the left heel down, warrior two. So in warrior two, shoulders stacked in line with the hips, reaching forward, powerful warrior. Left leg is strong, right knee is bent and that leg is strong. And breathe. So I think I may have switched the flow a little bit. We're doing the same poses, but the flow may be a little bit different if you notice that. But the poses are the same, the order just may be different. Let's reach both arms back up, lifting that left heel, drop that left knee down, lift the left knee from the mat. Drop it down and lift for two, drop it down for three, lift. Down, four, down, five, hold here, breathe. Right knee is bent, both hands to the mat, step the right foot back. Notice how it feels your right plank. And you can walk your knees out here, pedaling one knee down at a time. So press both heels back, straighten both legs. Try to bring your hips in line with your shoulders. Engage that core and meet in downward facing dog. Come forward, engage the core. Plank, down dog. Plank, down dog. Plank. Down dog, last one like this, plank, and down dog. We're going to start with the left foot this time. So left foot comes forward to the outside of our hands, sinking nice and deep into those hips. Step that foot back into down dog, and right foot comes forward outside of the right hand. Step it back. Inhale left, exhale down. Inhale right, exhale back. Inhale left, exhale. Inhale right, exhale. Inhale left and back. Inhale right, back, left, back, right, back. Hold, down dog. Press the heels into the mat. Roll the shoulders out. Navel towards the back. All four corners of the palm pressing into that mat as if you're pushing the mat away with your hands. Inhale, look forward, hop or walk the feet forward. Once again, just going based on how your body feels right now. Let's go ahead and just relax in this forward fold, but it's still a power move because we're keeping our legs straight here. Doesn't matter if your hands are to the ground or not. Let's reverse swan dive. So chin and chest guide us up towards the sky. Pull the hips forward, falling back just a little. And exhale, release. Shoulders move back, chest is lifted. Feet planted to the mat once again, palms forward, you're in that strong, powerful mountain pose. Connecting to the earth with your feet, keeping your face relaxed. Now from here, let's bend our knees. Drop the fingertips towards the ground. Maybe touch the mat with your hands. Reach your arms up and forward.
Lifting them towards the sky. Pull your hips forward. So you want to tuck your tailbone and look down. Can you see your toes? If you cannot, pull the knees back so you can.
Drop a little bit deeper here. Try to keep those shoulders relaxed.
So we don't want the shoulders hugging the ears. Try to keep everything relaxed. And breathe. Chair pose. Drop a little bit deeper in our chair pose. Bring your hands to the heart.
So we're going to switch focus. Whenever the hands come to the heart, usually for me, I'm about to switch our focus from shoulders to really focusing on legs only. Building some fire in those quads. Drop deeper. And breathe. Reminding you to breathe because it's really easy when we are in a pose that is uncomfortable to hold our breath, hoping it's going to be over soon. But breathe through it. Find your power by breathing through discomfort. And remembering the beautiful saying that the pose often begins the moment we want to come out of it. Now from here, we are working on balance. So we're going to step that right foot forward on our mat. Toes barely touching the mat.
Feel that left quad.
Lift the right foot and then drop the toes down. Lift the right foot, drop the toes down. Inhale, lift, exhale down. Maybe get that leg higher than the knee. Inhale, lift, exhale down. Lift, down, one more. Lift, exhale, bend that knee and just hold here.
So left knee is bent, right knee is bent. Don't lose that quad though. Sink into the chair.
And I'll drop the right foot down and switch sides. So right knee is bent and you're in chair pose. And as soon as you lift that left foot from the mat, there's instant relief on that leg. Enjoy it. So toes barely on the mat, right knee is bent, and lift the leg. Point the toes, drop that foot down. Inhale, we lift. Exhale, we lower. Inhale, we lift. Exhale, we lower. Inhale, we lift. Exhale, down. Inhale, lift. Exhale, down. One more. We lift. Bend that knee. Keep the foot pointed. Right knee is bent. Notice that right quad building fire. Sit deep here. Find your balance. And drop that foot down. Straighten both legs. Maybe you can walk the knees out. And just come back into standing. And breathe.
Nice work. We're going to shift our weight into the left foot, left leg. Right foot is going to come into tree pose. So I'll face you all so you can see what I'm doing. Left leg is on the mat, right foot, tree pose. So your toes can be touching the mat on that right foot, especially if the legs are feeling a little uneasy, maybe not too stable. However, you can lift the leg higher, higher, maybe eventually bringing that foot above the left knee. And let's find our balance. So I went into that a little bit fast, and that made my balance shaky. So in order to avoid that, let's take it slow. Go into your tree slowly. The beautiful thing about balance is that when we rush into something, we tend to fall out. When you take your time and tap in to your power, you find that you're more stable. So hands come to the heart, shoulders are back. And we want that knee pulled back, but both hips forward. And I'm just going to keep my hands where they are at the heart. And we are once again just focused on our breathing. And we're not worried how many times we fall out of the pose, come back in. The beautiful thing about yoga is that you are able to always find your way back into your pose if you would like. And remember, I'm just guiding you this practice. You listen to your body, you honor your body, you find your power by honoring your body and doing what is right for it. Now we're going to work on kicking the right foot out into star pose, and then we're going to bring the foot forward. So, on the exhale, we kick the leg out. Point the toes and lean your body towards the left. So right leg is lifted, kick that foot in line with the hip. Lift the leg higher. And with control, bring that right leg forward. Kick the foot up. Kick the foot up. Kick it up. And exhale, lower, release. Shake out that left leg if you need. Same thing, other side. So just like we're stronger on one side, we often also balance on one side a little bit better. So same thing, so you can always start with the foot on the mat or walk the foot as high as you would like. And there is no messing, that was me taking it too fast. So take it slow. Find your power by taking it slow, keeping it steady. And if one day you're able to get your foot higher than the other, that's normal. Our body goes through ebb and flow. There's no star, like I was saying earlier, no golden star for getting the foot to the groin. And there's no penalty for keeping the foot on the mat. This is your practice. As long as you're challenging yourself, you're doing yoga. You're doing what you set out to do. Now remember to keep the hips forward, left knee back. And really try to relax the shoulders. In some of my classes, every once in a while, I'll see someone in a tree pose or a balance pose, and their shoulders will be near their ears because they're so tense right now about falling out. But try to relax. Keep the shoulders down. And remember, if you fall out, come back in. It's just yoga. I'm not going to be mad. Tap into that right arch of the foot, right ankle. How does it feel? As it's building muscle memory, learning to balance. Practicing balance is so important. It's one of the first things that goes as we age. So really focus on your balance throughout your day. Now from here, we're going to kick that left foot out and lean to the right for star pose, and then we bring the foot forward and kick it up a few times. So let's start off by pointing the toes, kicking that leg out, and leaning. Lean, lean, lean. Now for me, the left leg can't go as high or is not going as high as the right foot went. That's okay. Doing what I can, balancing, you do what you can, you balance. Maybe your leg is higher than it was on the right. Now with control, bring that left foot forward. Try not to touch your mat, but if you need to, it's okay. Now lift that leg. Lift that leg. Lift that leg. Last one, lift. And exhale, release. Kick out that right foot, shake it out, and let that side go. Let it all go. Now we're going to come back to the top of our mat. We're going to meet in tree pose once again, and I'm going to transition into a crow. So if you want to work on that, feel free. Otherwise, you're welcome to meet in down facing dog. After chair pose. So we bend our knees, we scrape them out with our fingertips, we reach up to the sky, we pull our hips forward, bring the knees back. Find some intensity here. This is our last standing thing. So find that intensity. Drop your hands to the mat. And try to lift your toes, lift your heels, bring the knees to the triceps. If you can, bring the knees to the armpits. Shift your weight forward
Maybe you lift left foot from the mat. Maybe you play with coming down and up repeatedly until one day both feet are lifted. You work on straightening your arms. Now, this is a great time to grab some pillows if you're not familiar with crow pose, or to ignore crow pose completely, up to you. But we're going to hold this, if we are in crow, for 3, 4, and on 5, shoot the legs back if you can, meeting in chaturanga. Inhale, forward and through, up dog. First up dog, and exhale, down dog. Roll those shoulders out. Enjoy that down dog. How does your body feel? Do you feel powerful right now? Let's inhale through the nose 3 times. We're going to exhale with that mouth open like we did earlier. So inhale. Look forward on the top of your mat, and we're just going to walk the feet forward a little bit. So halfway point. And what we're going to do is we're going to work on donkey kicks. So we're going to lift right leg up and have the left foot tap the leg. So I'm starting off with the side that is actually not as comfortable for me. So I'm going to tuck my shirt in so everything's not just hanging all out. We're going to bring our hands to the mat. Right leg's going to go up, and the left foot's going to try to tap. So this is what it could look like. Right foot up, left leg comes up like this. Maybe you can get that leg higher, and you can kick the leg. So we're going to do it 3 times. 1, 2, 3. Walk the feet up again. Same thing, other side. So left leg comes up as high as you would like. And maybe that just barely is off the ground. And we're going to try to tap the foot. Right foot on the left leg, left foot, or wherever the foot lands. For 1, 2, 3. Walk both feet forward once more. And let's just come down to the knees. Walking the feet back, bringing ourselves into a camel pose. So, knees are on the mat, hip width distance, 2 fists. Bring them in between your knees, that's as far apart as you would like them. Hands go to the lower back, hips go forward. And I want you to pull your hips forward so much that it's as if you're going to touch the front wall. Shoulders back, chin is lifted. If that's too much tension for the neck, gaze is forward. And just hang out here for a moment. So power doesn't always mean hard or impossible. I feel like sometimes in yoga, especially when we think of powerful yogis, we think of people who are standing on their head and getting their legs behind their head. And that stuff is cool, but that's not what I mean when I say power. I mean tapping into yourself when you think, oh, I can't hold this anymore. But then you hold it for another breath and another breath. That's power. Now from here, bring the shoulders in line with the hips. Bring your hands down to the mat. Bring your feet together. Sink your hips back into your heels. And let's just walk the hands forward for a moment, dropping your head down and resting. Resting in a child's pose. Walk your hands back. Come back into the knees, feet apart. One more camel. So just doing two of them. Push your hips forward, fall back. Now, if you want to try to reach back with your hands for your ankles, go ahead. You can curl your toes if you would like in order to add a little bit more leverage to grab onto. And you can take right hand back and left hand back. But if you grab hold of your ankles or your heels and your hips go back like this, come out of it. Keep the power in the hips. Push those hips forward. Don't lose the hips here just to grab hold of the ankles. Be true to your body. Find power in yourself by being true to your body. Now, if your hands are on the ankles or heels, bring your hands back to the lower spine. Slowly come out of it. Bring your toes to the mat. Sink your hips to your heels. And we're going to round our spine. So hands walk forward to the knees. And we're going to round our back, shoulders forward, face, chin is down. Walk your knees together if they're apart. And slowly drop your forehead to the knees. Oh, that feels so good. One of my favorite stretches to do after back bending. In this forward fold, we want the forehead connected to our knees and the crown of the head, if we're able to, try to get it on the mat. Take your hands behind your legs to your feet. Keep your forehead and knees connected and lift your hips from the mat just for a moment. Maybe that helps intensify the stretch. And exhale down. Let's roll the body up. Shoulders in, hips in the same line. Take your hands to one side and the feet to the other, coming into a seated position on our mat. Let's do a few forward folds. We're going to bring the right foot into the left thigh for tree pose. Twist over that right knee, getting the hip into alignment. Inhale, lift both arms towards the sky. Pull that right shoulder forward and lean forward from the left foot. Inhale, look forward, straighten that back. And exhale, drop down a little bit deeper. Inhale, look forward, and exhale. Let's release. Let's step the right foot out, left foot into tree pose. Twist over that left knee. Feel that hip get into place. Inhale, lift both arms up. Push the right shoulder back. Lean forward, grab hold of that right foot. Look forward, straighten the spine, and exhale. Drop deep here. Really try to relax in this. Keep the back long. Hang out for a moment. Make sure that that left shoulder is dropped in line with the right. Inhale, look forward, and exhale. Let's release. Let's kick both feet out. Shake up the legs. Move the fleshy part from your sit bones so that your sit bones are planted into the mat. Inhale, lift your arms and exhale. Grab hold of your ankles or your toes, maybe the knees. Keep the back long, look forward, and go a little bit deeper here. Now make sure those shoulders aren't hugging the ears. Keep your shoulders relaxed and down. Are you breathing? Breathe in and out through the nose. Find that power. Inhale and exhale. Let's release. Let's point our toes. And this is a beautiful power move because in order for this to happen, you've got to find the power in you. Take the hands behind you. Shoulders back, fingertips pointed in, toes pointed. So point those toes, and we are going to lift our hips up to the sky. And as you lift the hips up, your toes stay together. So it's going to, your hips are going to lift, and your feet are going to want to part in order for the toes to touch the ground. But fight, keep it together. Find your power and bring those toes together. Lift your hips as high as you can. Maybe your hips don't lift as high as you think that they should or would. Breathe through it and lift your hips higher. Maybe your toes touch the mat, maybe not. Doesn't matter. Lift those hips, drop that head back, and lift. Lift. And exhale, release. Bring the knees to the chest, wrap the arms around the legs, and drop the forehead to the mat. Nice job. Inhale, look forward, and exhale, release. Let's keep the left knee bent. Bring that right ankle over the left knee. Hands behind your back. Now, this could be intense enough for those hips. We haven't done too much with the hips today, so we're just going to stretch them out a little bit before we finish. If you want more intensity, walk your left heel back, maybe push yourself forward, and bring your right knee towards the front of the room. And breathe. You can also walk your hands in a little bit more, getting your shoulders in line with the hips, and that's going to help intensify the stretch in that right hip as well. So it's a more gentle way to open the hip than going into lizard or pigeon pose. And let's release that right foot down, left ankle crosses over, and my left hip is so much more tight than the right. But if you're feeling like it can go deeper, go ahead and walk that foot back, bring your hips forward, and really mentally push that right or left knee forward. The more you push here, imagining that knee going forward, the deeper the stretch in the hip. So even though you're moving the knee, you're stretching out that hip. And exhale, release. Let's bring our feet together. I'll face you all. So feet together for cobbler pose. Once again, the more space you have between your pelvis and your heels, the less intense. So you choose how deep you want to go. Open your feet, your soles of your feet, shoulders back, elbows to the thighs, and lean forward. Use your elbows to press the thighs down, which is over time, you press the knees down, and over time, the hips open more. It's a very gradual thing. But as you do that, don't hug your ears with your shoulders. Keep the shoulders relaxed here. The back is long, just hang out, breathe. And release. Let's kick both feet out, shake out the legs, and let's lay down on our mat. So we're just going to bring ourselves all the way down, laying down on the mat. Wiggle your hips, wiggle your shoulders. Find a comfortable position. This is our final pose. Just stretching it out. Take a few moments for yourself, taking back a little bit of your power in your day. We spend so much time in our day hustling and bustling about. Take back your power and give yourself a couple of moments in Savasana. Quieting your mind and your body. Often the hardest pose for people. I want to thank you for your practice. Thank you for joining me on your mat. I hope you found your power. I hope you feel powerful because you are. I hope you have a great day. Namaste.